Have you ever noticed how the ESP32 is just everywhere these days? It's no surprise, it packs a powerful CPU, built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth low energy, all in a tiny form factor. That makes it perfect for embedding in all kinds of smart projects. But there's one thing that can quickly turn from convenience to headache: updating the firmware. Connecting a cable every single time just is impractical, especially once your project is deployed or sealed inside an enclosure. Sure, OTA over Wi-Fi is possible, but what happens when the Wi-Fi network changes? You could use an access point mode, but modern smartphones do not like staying connected without an internet access. Plus, many ESP32 devices do not support 5 GHz Wi-Fi. And explaining the update process, let's say to your parents, that's not fun. This is where BLE OTA shines. It's slightly slower than Wi-Fi, but nothing deal breaker. And especially if you're updating your ESP32 occasionally, it's more than enough. And best of all, it works with both Android and iOS. In this video, I'll walk you through how to update your ESP32 firmware over BLE using Arduino IDE. Whether you are a hobbyist or developing real-world IoT devices, this method can save you a lot of headache down the line. I'm Rupak and welcome to the channel. Let's dive right in. You can use any ESP32 boards that you have with you. I'll be using the one that I created myself, mainly because it has 4 addressable LEDs and it'll save me some wiring time for the example that I'm going to show you. So I'll just simply attach it to the computer that has Arduino IDE. This is the GitHub repository for the project. Here you'll find some useful information and all the starter code you need to be able to update your ESP32 over Bluetooth Low Energy. Upon scrolling to the end, you'll find 2 links to download the app on your iPhone or your Android phone. So go ahead and download the app and also download the zip file for the repository, or you may clone it. After downloading the zip file, go ahead and unzip it and open the ESP32 folder and further the OTA over BLE folder. Here you'll find an Arduino project, and that's what we'll be dealing with today. If you have seen my previous video, you'll find this starter code very similar to what I had for the serial monitor over Bluetooth low energy example. The only difference is this code incorporates the callbacks and the functions to be able to flash an OTA update. Don't get overwhelmed by the amount of code that I have here. You don't need to understand any of it. And I'll explain you shortly how you can use this code in your own project. But before we do that, let's just flash this raw code to our ESP32 board without making any changes. So I will simply go ahead and select my board. And select the port. And I'll simply flash it to my ESP32 board. After flashing the code to the ESP32 board, we can open the Wible app on our phone and head to the serial monitor section. The ESP32 is advertising itself as Wible, which is also the name of the app. So simply select it to establish a connection. Here we see some counter values appearing on our phone, which verifies that the code is working and our ESP32 is ready to receive updates over Bluetooth Low Energy. We can simply close the app for now. I will now simply transition to use a dedicated power supply to power my ESP32. Instead of a USB cable to avoid any data communication with my PC. Let's modify this starter code to, let's say, flash the lights on my ESP32 board in blue color. And for that, we'll head back to our old friend ChatGPT to generate us a simple code. I'll provide it the prompt. So here we have a simple code to blink the LEDs on my ESP32 board in blue color.
So what I'll try to do now is to incorporate this code generated by ChatGPT in the starter code that we had before. So I am going to copy the header file and the helper code and place it on top like we usually do with other Arduino codes. Now I'm gonna head down to the void setup function inside the starter code and look out for the last line. You can place whatever setup you want here, and you can basically treat it like a normal void setup function in Arduino. So I'm going to copy the void setup from the void setup generated by ChatGPT into the void setup of our starter code. And I'm going to do a similar thing for the void loop. The only difference is if you see this if condition here, it only executes when the device is connected to Bluetooth and an OTA update is not in progress. This was necessary for the counter code that I showed you before, but because we are no longer dealing with it, we can get rid of the device connected condition, and we can also eliminate all the code required to display the counter values. I'm now going to copy all the void loop from the code generated by ChatGPT into this if condition. And now we are ready to see if our code compiles without any errors. All right, it compiles without any errors. So instead of flashing the code like we usually do, I'll go to the sketch option and select export compiled binary. This will compile the file again, and after it's done compiling, you'll see a new folder called build in our original directory which contained the project. And inside the build folder, you'll see another folder. And because we are dealing with ESP32 and further with ESP32C6 in my case, it's gonna create a folder for that. And you'll see some files here. Now the number of files may not be the same depending on what version of the Arduino IDE that you are using, but you are looking for a file that has the .ino.bin extension, which is right here. So to avoid confusion, I'm going to rename it to, let's say, blue.ino.bin. And you can now place this file on your phone however you want. Because I'm using an iPhone with MacBook, I'm going to use AirDrop, but you can use a cable or you can email it to yourself. Now I have the file on my phone, so let's head back to the Weibel app. But this time we'll select the OTA update option. And again, we'll select Weibel, which corresponds to our ESP32 device. After the connection has been established, we can select the file, which is right here. And we can hit start. Hopefully when the progress bar reaches 100%, we'll see some blue color. It is relatively quick in transferring the file to the ESP32 board, and it also handles all the errors. So let's say if you hit close, or if you shut off your app, or if your ESP32 loses power, it's not going to brick the device in 99% of the cases. So as you can see, it's working, and I can keep doing this again and again and again, however many times I want.
And with that, we come to the end of the tutorial. I hope this opens new possibilities for your projects and makes updating ESP32s a whole lot easier. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and rate the app. My name is Rupak, and I'll be back soon with another exciting project. Until then, happy building.